Welcome back. So just last week, Vice President Kamala Harris had an interesting answer when asked about the biggest threat our country is facing. Of course, it seems like she misheard the question and maybe instead answered to what she thinks the biggest threat facing Democrats is.
What is the thing that worries you and keeps you up at night?
Frankly, one of them is our democracy.
So it's our democracy that's such a big threat to Democrats, that is. Because by judging their mishandling of every crisis over the past year and their current polling numbers, our democracy is set to deal the party a blow this upcoming November, which is why it makes complete sense that after the abject failure of the Build Back Better Act to pass the Congress, the White House's focus now turns back to passing voting rights legislation. With Harris in the same interview on CBS stating that the United States won't be a role model of democracy if the legislation isn't passed. Listen to this.
Right now, we're about to take ourselves off the map as a role model. And I'm talking about what's not happening in this Capitol in Washington, D.C., which is the passing of the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act and the Freedom to Vote Act.
I mean, so folks, can we just take a step back and look at how ridiculous that statement is? I mean, first of all, by saying that we won't be a role model for democracy if the legislation isn't passed, she's essentially saying that the U.S. has never been a role model for democracy. We know that's completely untrue. And second, there is not a single person in America over the age of 18 that hasn't been convicted of a felony that is denied the right to vote. Passing the Democrats' voting rights legislation would actually mean the exact opposite of strengthening a republic. It would forever tilt the election process in favor of the Democrats, putting them in power in perpetuity. What we need is election integrity legislation, not the Democrats' bogus voting rights bill. Here's reaction to this is Speak Georgia co-founder, political commentator Janelle King, and Joe Concha, who is also back with us. So Janelle, the Freedom to Vote Act actually overrides states on voter ID and redistricting. Isn't this just a ploy by Democrats to tilt things in their favor, to game the system?
Absolutely. But most importantly, we have to highlight that this is their midterm strategy, because if for Democrats, this is a win-win for them regardless. If they win it and the bill passes, everything's going to be fine for them. They're going to move forward. But if they lose, then they're going to now make this the talking point going forward. They're going to energize their base in the way like we've never seen before. They're already selling that this bill does not only protect voting rights, but that it protects abortion rights along with holding back any type of other racist policies that's going to come from Republicans. I think this is where the strategy that's going to come into in the midterms. And, you know, I want to make sure everyone understands that this is very, very important. And on a personal level, you know, my husband is running for U.S. Senate, Kelvin King, right here in Georgia, and he'll be running up against Raphael Warnock. And we are in the cradle of the civil rights movement. And not only that, but Raphael Warnock considers himself to be the civil rights leader. And he's also the most vulnerable Senate candidate that we have right now. And I think it's important to understand that with keeping all of this in mind, that they are going to use this as a talking point going forward, and that this is going to be their game plan, and that we have to make sure that we have the right messaging to combat this. We got to make sure we have the right candidates moving forward that can step toe-to-toe with these candidates, as well as those who can articulate the message and be able to bring forward what's really going on, and that this is a huge strategy that's coming out of the left. Because clearly, Democracy is most certainly at stake, but it's due to poor policies.
That's a good point. They're going to blame it on, oh, the system was unfair. This is why we lost. We wouldn't have lost if we had these laws. That's a good point. You know, Joe, what I can't understand is somehow it's okay to have to show a vaccine passport to even eat at a restaurant in New York City, but somehow a voter ID, did an ID to vote is racist? I mean, can you help me wrap my head around this? I don't understand.
I'll try my best. Look, it's funny that in Georgia, Lisa, for example, Stacey Abrams can say that the election was stolen from her, and she is hailed as a media darling. Hillary Clinton can say that the Russians helped Donald Trump steal the election from her, and that's A-OK. But then if the 45th president does it, well, it's a chilling threat to democracy. Look, let me help the vice president out here for a second. The biggest threat to this country is China, or maybe it's inflation, a tax on everybody, particularly the low and middle class. It's Afghanistan, which is now a terrorist playground for the Taliban and ISIS and Al-Qaeda. It's violent crime that is affecting American cities now, engulfing them. 16 cities now have homicide rates at record numbers at this point. So let's not talk about voting rights being the biggest threat to this country. It's all the things that the Biden administration is failing at this point. The bottom line is that the United States right now is a role model for voting, for democracy. And know this, Lisa, a federal takeover of elections from the states would be the very death of democracy. Apparently, ending 24/7 voting centers is a threat to democracy. So if you want to vote at 3 a.m. on a Tuesday, 3 weeks before an election, that's a threat, apparently. And asking a voter for identification before entering the ballot box, I'm sorry, that's too much to ask. The Associated Press found that 72% of American adults, we're basically talking 3 in 4, approve of requiring a photo ID to vote. Again, like the border, Kamala Harris is disconnected from the American people, and it's why she isn't a plan B for Joe Biden. She's a plan NW, as in no way this person cannot be president if Joe Biden does not run, Lisa.
I mean, they're both terrible. We're actually going to put up a list of the failures, but we just simply didn't have time in the show. So, Janelle and Joe, thanks
finite
so much
time.
For joining us. We appreciate it.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.